this. I can't forget the time or place where we just met. Just a girl to me and all, but I want the world to see me dead. Had it been another day, I would be the other way. I am falling, and she keeps falling, leaving me back there. I have never known the likes of this. I've been a I was Sore Fingers again with you. Thanks indeed for joining me for hopefully another interesting guitar lesson. That one is really moves along, I tell you. Right, that was obviously the classic song from the Beatles, I've Just Seen a Face. Okay, standard tuning, no capos, doing it in the same key that the original album came out, Help album, the recording on that album, okay, is in the key of A. You'll see later years, Paul McCartney live seems to be playing it in G. I'm not sure if he is, but it looks like he's playing it in G. But the original version was in A, okay? So that's what we're doing, okay? So, starts off with the iconic... sorry, I couldn't keep up with the vocals. I can't sing all of this and play it at the same time. I keep losing the words, as you probably noticed, but you get the idea, don't you? So let's get to it. So it starts off the intro, which is quite tricky on its own right, because it's, again, all fairly quick. Starts off with these two notes. You can play it two ways. You can play an open A string, and then the fourth fret of the bottom E string. Or you can go from the fifth fret on the bottom E string to the fourth fret on the bottom E string. It's up to you, okay? So then we start off with some double picking notes, okay? So starts off, I'm using my, for this, you use whichever fingers suits you best, okay? I'm using my second finger and third finger. My second finger is playing the second fret of the third string, and my third finger is playing the second fret of the top E string. And basically it's 3-3-1-3-1-3-1, okay? Right. That slowly, even slower, got that, so you've got this, right, then we go up to the next shape, which I'm using my first finger and second finger. First finger is playing the fifth fret of the top E string, and my second finger is playing the sixth fret of the third string, the G string, and it's the same sort of da 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 so. Got that? So far we've got this. It's very quick, I'll tell you. It's normal speed, okay? This is a bit slower than normal speed. Right, that's the first two shapes. Third shape is this one. And what I would say, I mean, I don't, it's up to you, I say, use whatever fingers suits you best. From this shape, I would suggest that you use the same two fingers. and go up to the 9th fret on the top E string with your first finger, and your second finger play the 11th fret of the 3rd string. Same idea. Okay, so now you've got this. Right, and now what we've got, because you've got the shape you've got there, the next one is made easier because you've got this shape. Because what you do now is you slide your second finger, this one, up to the 14th fret of the 3rd string, and the 3rd finger takes over the 14th fret of the top E string, and you back to this. Again, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Yep, so now we've got this. Except I didn't use the fingers I just told you. Let's try that again, using the fingers I just said. Okay, got that far? Right, now we go down to this shape. Again, first finger, top E string on the 10th fret, and second finger on the 11th fret of the 3rd string. Now we've got that, so let's do this. Sorry. That's as far as we've got, yeah. Now we go up one fret on the 3rd string to the 12th fret, and my 3rd finger is taking over duty on the 12th fret on the top E string. Okay, so now we've got this. So you've got those two there, both on the 12th fret, 3rd string and the top E string, yeah? So let's do that slowly. Swap fingers a bit there, but you get there, you know, whatever fingers, I can't help it, my fingers do their own thing sometimes, not what I think they should do, they just do it, okay? And then from that one, on the 12th fret, you take that exact shape up to the 14th fret on the 3rd string and the 14th fret on the top E string. So now we've got this. And what you do on that one is you stay there, okay? You stay there for another one, okay? Another session of the picking, okay? So what we've got now is this. Two lots of picking on that one, okay? Then we go down to this shape. First finger is now playing the 12th fret of the top E string, and my second finger is playing the 13th fret of the G string. Okay, just the usual picking on that, just a single load of picking. Okay, and then we take that down two frets, finally, to the 10th fret on the 1st string and the 11th fret on the G string, the 3rd string, and a single strum pattern on that. Picking pattern, sorry, not strum pattern. Okay, and that's it. So if you put that whole lot together, you should have this slowly. Twice on this one. To the song, back to the A chord for the beginning of the song. Okay, so once again, very slowly. Okay, here we go. very, very slowly. Okay, now doing it the way I showed you with it, when you come from this one and you keep those two fingers in use and you slide it up to this one, if you use that you also get a slide in action in go, which is quite good. So it goes like this. Yeah, get slide that, yeah, because you're keeping this finger in going. That using that third thing string, the third string fretting is constantly using this second finger, so you can slide it when you change shapes. Okay, got it? Got the idea? This finger's staying there all the time on that string for most of it. And it can slide from one to the other. It gives it quite a nice sound. Okay, so let's do it slowly. See, every time you change shape, you slide down. All right, got the idea? Okay, practice makes perfect. Okay, so just giving you a pause. Okay, that's almost normal speed, I think. Right, so the chord, the song itself. Right, so let's just go away and practice that. That'll keep you busy for a while. Right, the chords to the song are very simple, but they're very quick. Okay, so I've just seen an A. We start on an A chord. Okay, so after you come out of that, I've just seen a face I can't forget. Now, obviously, you've got to try and get these bass runs in if you can. You don't have to, but it does make the song, I think. I've just seen a face I can't forget. Fourth fret of the bottom E string, and then you go to an F sharp minor. And you really need to use a bar chord for this, because otherwise you won't be able to do the runs properly. Okay, so F sharp, second fret bar chord, minor shape, playing the fifth string and the fourth string on the fourth fret there with the two fingers and the bar on the second fret. Okay, so I've just seen a face I can't forget. Right, second on the fourth fret of the fifth string. Let's start that again. Fourth fret of the bottom E string. Okay, from the A. Okay, and then we go to the F sharp minor and hitting that. Hitting that second on the sixth string and then strumming. Okay. Then you hit that second on the sixth again. Then the bottom E string open, and then go to the D chord and hit the open fourth string first. So now you've got this. I just see the things I can't forget. Alright, got the idea, got the idea. So you. In a second. So from the beginning, I've just seen a face I can't forget, the time or the place where we go. bam, bam, open D string, four strings, strummed D. Right, so we hit that open D again. Fourth fret of the fifth string with pinky, keeping the D shape. Right. Second fret of the fifth string. So, open fifth string. Fourth fret of the sixth string. And then we're back to the A and the A chord. Okay, so I'll just play the single notes if you want. Don't bother trying to strum anything during. Right. I mean, if you want to strum, you can, but you can just concentrate on hitting those notes. Okay, got it? So the whole thing is, I can see your face, I can't forget the time your face were eager. Very slowly. I just see a face I can't forget. Then it repeats the whole thing again. Okay, another verse. It'd be another day. My breath would be another day. Open four strings, strum the D, then pinky goes up to that fourth fret of the fifth string, second fret of the fifth string, open fifth string, fourth fret of the sixth string, the bottom E string, and then open A string, A chord. Got that? Right, so that's the two verses, and then it goes into the chorus, okay? And the chorus is straightforward, it's E, so coming out of that, E chord, D, falling, yes I am D, falling, and she keeps A, calling, back to D, me back to A again. Okay, so that's the chorus, okay, so E, falling, yes I am D, falling, and she keeps A, calling, D, me back at A, calling, got that? Do it again for you. Falling, yes I am D falling, and she A calling, D, me back to A. And it goes into another verse, okay? Into another chorus. Falling, yes I am calling, keeps me calling, me back again. Okay, now we come to the solo. For those of you who want to play it, okay, it's very, very simple. Right, starts off on an open A string. Up to the second fret on the A string, and then off again. So it's... And up to the 4th fret on the A string, open A string, okay, so, up to the 5th fret on the A string, okay, so, it goes down from the 5th fret to the 4th fret, all on the A string, to the 2nd fret. Okay? And then open A string again. Open A string. Right, so got that so far. It almost repeats itself there. Okay, so it's open A string, second, open, fourth fret, open, fifth fret, fourth fret, second fret, right? Right, let's do it again. Open again, second, fourth, open, fifth, fourth. It just repeats that bit twice, yeah? Right? Second on the fourth, fifth, second on fifth, open fifth, right, fourth fret of the sixth string, second fret on the sixth string, back to the fourth fret on the sixth string, open A string, chord, A chord, and then straight into the chorus. Falling, you are falling. Right, so let's just go through that very slowly for you, okay? So that's the solo for you, okay? And then he goes into the chorus again. Yes, we are calling. Now that's first. As usual, same as usual. I've just seen your face. I can't forget. Chorus. Now this time it repeats on the end of the song. It repeats the chorus. Does the chorus three times? Okay, so the first time we've just done. And we lead into the E again. Open A string. 4th fret of the 6th string, bottom E string, 2nd fret, bottom E string, and then into the chorus again. So, from the first time you come into it, and again. Right, on the last chorus, you stay on the D, me back again. You do that run again, we go open D string, strum. Fourth on the fifth string, second on the fifth string, open fifth string, fourth on the sixth string, and then an A chord, and that's the end of the song. So, this is the very last one. Falling, you are falling, you are falling, be back. So there you have it, all the parts of the song that you need to play it, hopefully. It is very quick, I can tell you that now for now. It's one of the fastest songs I think I've ever played. Anyway, thanks very much for watching this, and I'll see you in the next video. Keep safe. and well, and I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.